Hello and welcome back to Module 5 of this Games-Based Learning course as part of the European SchoolNet Academy. Module 5 is all about designing games. In this second unit, we're going to have a quick look at some simple games design tools. In particular, we're probably going to be thinking about some of these tools and how they could be used for quite young children. The first thing to say, of course, is that in order to teach the principles of games design, sometimes some non-computer games are probably a very, very good place to start. You remember we talked about Mousetrap back in Module 1. Another good place to start is maybe some tools that aren't actually designed for creating computer games. Microsoft PowerPoint or Apple's Keynote springs to mind. Because with these tools, you can actually get young people to develop quite specific narrative-driven games or mystery games. Here's an example here, where we're trying to get inside a house as part of a mystery game which has been designed by very, very young children. You can see that what's happened is that the action buttons have been put in here to actually change the direction and the flow of the story. Let's see what happens if we try to open the gate rather than to climb the fence. Oh no, we've tried to open the gate, but that set off the alarm. It means the game's over, but I can quickly click back and start again. Hopefully you see the point. It's not just about complicated computer coding, it's also about telling stories and also making sure that we include some very, very simple variables in any games that we develop. PowerPoint and Apple's Keynote allows us to do this simply and easily. And over time, young people can actually build up incredibly complicated stories, or we can start to combine presentations, or games in this case, to actually get young people working together. There's lots of other more specific games design tools though. One of my favourites is a game called Too Simple DIY. Too Simple DIY is a commercially available game from the Too Simple software company. We've used it a lot in Scottish schools and the children and young people really seem to like it. You can develop a whole range of games using Too Simple DIY. I think some of the best games that I've seen using Too Simple DIY across Europe have come from Porchester Junior High School. Another really, really good and simple games design tool is something called Scratch Junior. Lots of people have already heard of Scratch, but I'm always surprised as to how many few people have heard about Scratch Junior. Scratch Junior is available for the iPad, but it will also be available for Android platform towards the end of 2014. If you're familiar with Scratch, then you'll also be familiar with some of the features of Scratch Junior. The difference, of course, is it's got a lot more of a childlike or young childlike interface. And of course it's optimised for touch because it's designed to be used on a tablet computer. So that brings us to the end of our first little video there. What I want you to do is I want you to think about, could you use any of these tools in your classroom? How might you work with very young children so they could design their own computer game?